gonna ditch the streets, we're gonna tell them.
I'm SB Barber, and I have decided to take it to the street. We've taken the walls off of our internet radio and TV, GMNLive.com, and we are doing a series of forums in the community and on air talking about Stop Bullying Now. I want your opinion. You don't have to give your name unless you want to, but what does bullying look like to you, and what do you think about it?
Well, bully to me, that's cowardness, to be honest with you. Anytime, you know, you could feel like you could push over someone and you do it just because you can. I mean, go push to somebody that's going to give you a struggle. So bullying, that's cowardness to me. That's
so
my opinion.
So for an individual that, you know what, they're hearing you say that and it's like, wow, I really don't want to do that, but all the peer pressure, maybe I am bullying, but how do I get out of it?
Just look at it like, say if you're, I mean, the bullying, it don't necessarily have to be an individual. It could be the government or anything, you know what I'm saying? But the thing is, I mean, if you don't want nobody taking advantage of you, why take advantage of someone else? So just try to put yourself in that position, you know. Hopefully you got feelings,
right.
You know. So if you don't want your feelings hurt, you know, bullying people, that hurt their feelings too. So
all right. It's
all forms of bullying, but, you know, I don't appreciate it. But.
This is GMNLive.com on the streets. And would you like to tell everyone who you are?
My name is Troy.
Thank you, Troy.
All right.
Hello, young lady. May I speak with you just for a moment? Stop bullying now. We're on the streets, GMNLive.com, TV and radio, taking it to the streets with a series of Stop Bullying Now movement forums. And I'd like to know from your perspective for young people, what do you think bullying is, or what does it mean to you? What does it look like to you?
Someone taking advantage of a helpless person.
Have you ever been the victim of being a bully? Or, all right, and they say now, statistics-wise, is that in the schools on campuses, 75 to 95% of the students are bystanders. What does that mean to you?
I don't know, because I've never, like, been in a bully situation. So, I don't know.
But being a bystander, when you see people being taken advantage of, that's that bystander.
It's wrong. They shouldn't do that. I think it's very wrong. I be feeling sorry for them because they just helpless and they just bullying them and stuff. But there's nothing you can do. Like, they're going to keep doing it.
Can the bystanders really make a difference?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they can. They can stop it, but most times they don't.
Do you have any inkling as to why? Fear?
Maybe. Probably scared of retaliation or what the bully will do to them for helping out the person that's being bullied. So, probably fear.
So if you could give just maybe one or two pieces of advice to that bystander that really down in their hearts they know it's wrong, what could you say to them to take a stance?
Like, if they see somebody getting bullied, like, even if it's fear, like, it will be, like, you know, it will make a difference if they help. It will make a big difference for them to help. I think they should help.
GMNLive.com on the streets. And would you like for everyone to know who you are?
No.
All right. That's quite all right. But
thank
you're
you.
Beautiful. Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. Hello, gentlemen. Quick Stop Bullying Now movement. I'm GMNLive.com. I'm SB Barber, taking it to the street. You've got some young people right here. Just want to know, what does bullying look like to you?
I don't know.
You don't know?
What does what look like?
Bullying.
Bullying.
Stop Bullying Now movement. We want our kids to go back to school empowered, to be no bullying zones. And 75 to 95% of our kids in schools take up the bystander. In other words, they see it happening, they let it happen.
I don't know. For me, it was just a part of growing up. I got shoved in a locker my freshman year in high school.
Did they know you'd get this tall?
No. No.
They wouldn't do it now.
Yeah, they wouldn't do it now.
Okay, but you can relate to it.
Yeah, I mean, I just kind of thought it was part of it. You know, it's not a great part of high school, but it can be taken way too far. But
when is it taken too far? Okay, you got shoved in the lockers. Here you are standing almost 6 feet mm-hmm. here, et cetera. And, of course, no one's going to do that. Maybe corporate America, maybe the government a little bit. But the bottom line is, what can we say to our young people when it's taken too far?
I don't know.
You just need to stand up against it.
Come on a little bit closer.
You need to stand up against it. I mean, really. I mean, my son's been bullied, and it's not a fun thing to have to deal with. So. I mean, even as a parent, you have to make sure that you identify it and nip it in the bud right away.
That's what I'm talking about. Right. Nip it in the bud right now. Okay, when you go to the schools and tell them, now does our children, does my child feel safe when now here comes dad? I really want dad to stand up with me and for me. Oh, but now I'm really going to get put in the locker.
Right. I mean, so I had to talk to my son ahead of time to, you know, make sure that he knew what was going to happen. So, I mean, it's a hard thing as a parent to have to deal with. So,
my dad told me there'd be bullies out there and, you know, don't fight if you don't have to, but.
But you also have to stand up for yourself, too. You know, at a certain point, if you're getting bullied, you need to stand up for yourself.
Excellent. So can we make our schools no bullying zones? Is it really possible?
I don't think it's going to be possible. I think that you can strive for that, but I don't think that it's a realistic expectation.
Yeah.
Kids are going to be kids. You know, certain kids are going to think they're better than other kids and, you know, put down other kids. I think that's just a real, you know.
I think it's a great goal, but I don't know how you'd get it done.
Tell some parents, what should they do when they see the signs that their child is being bullied?
I mean, I just engaged my son's teacher. You know, I sent her an email, said this is what he's coming home saying is happening, look into it, make sure it doesn't happen again. Then they took it to the principal and all that, but, you know, and then they took care of it right then and there and had, you know, brought in the appropriate people and had the conversation, so.
Thank you. That's why we're taking it to the streets. We want to know what do we see it as and what does it look like? You said status quo. It became part of the norm. Taking it too far. Parents need to get involved and listen to their children.
Absolutely.
I'm SB Barber with GMNLive.com, taking it to the street, and we have our series going on right now. Stop bullying now. You break that seal. Give it to someone that can appreciate it. And we will be at the Capri Theater on August 27th. Three series of concerts and a panel with authors, media personalities, playwrights, and political individuals talking about what you're saying. All right. Thank you. Hi. Can you talk to me for just a quick moment? Are you on your way to work? Turn around to this camera very quickly.
Okay.
I'm SB Barber, and I'm taking it to the streets with Stop Bullying Now. We have a series that's going on at the Capri Theater, concerts with artists that are willing to say, if you really knew me, Stop Bullying Now movement. What does bullying look like to you? And will you look at that camera because you're gorgeous and tell them who you are.
I'm Autumn Butler.
How old are you, Autumn?
I'm 13.
Wow, you are exactly where I needed to go right now. I've been talking to a lot of adults and they have an opinion. Tell me your opinion.
My opinion on it? I guess, I don't know. I think bullying needs to stop, but it just depends on, you know, I don't know.
What do you think about the bystanders? We've been talking about the bullies, but bystanders can make a difference, but?
I don't know.
That's all right. What would you like to see happen differently on your school campus as it relates to kids that are being bullied and nobody's coming to the forefront to say anything in their behalf?
Well, I can't really say anything right about that because I'm homeschooled.
All right. Okay. But if you had the opportunity to speak out and this is your voice,
what
would you say?
I think that bullying does need to stop in like certain ways, like that if you're not cool enough, that you're not able to be with certain people or hang out with certain people. And in that sense, yeah, I would think that it would need to stop.
That's very brave of you to share this, Autumn. Thank you. GMNLive.com. You go to our website and you'll see our concert series that are coming up August 27th at the Capri from 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock. 50 minutes nonstop hip-hop artists talking about if you really knew me, Stop Bullying Now movement. Thank you, Autumn. All right. Who do I have standing here?
I'm your mom, and I didn't want to interrupt you while you were doing that, but
Mom, can we hear how you feel about our children being bullied at school? Or because another gentleman was talking about from a parent standpoint. He said that it hurt his heart to see his son going through it, so he had to go to the school. Some parents won't do it. What can you say, Mom?
Well, I think as far as any kind of bullying,
Mom, can we have you on?
I think it takes for, I would have to say, parents to step in and be a part of their children's lives, one, to understand that the children are not perfect, that every child that, you know, as far as like a parent whose child is doing the bullying, that yes, your child can do this. Sometimes you just, some children I do believe need to just kind of toughen up a little bit, and not everything is taken, not take things so personally. I had an older brother who committed suicide, and so it's like I know kind of the effects that sometimes bullying can have on people. As a Mexican American person, I've experienced bullying from teachers growing up and from students, and it made me the person who I am today, which I'm grateful for. But at the same time, you know, you can't stop it. It's something that's gone on for ages and ages and ages. It'll continue to go on. What you need to do is prepare your children that it can be you may experience this, and how to deal with it correctly.
Because we know, as an example, like you said, you're who you are today,
right?
And so you're assertive. But then we've got kids that are committing suicide because they can't take it any longer.
Well, I don't necessarily agree that that's the reason that kids commit suicide. I tend to also know from my own experience, and then getting involved with that sort of thing, that people who tend to commit suicide have underlying problems as well. As not, the bullying just kind of helps, it compresses it, but they also tend to have other, if it wouldn't have been the bullying, it would eventually be something else that caused them to commit suicide. So that's kind of that's kind of my view on that. So
is this your beautiful family?
This is. We're actually
wonderful.
Getting ready to. Okay. We're trying to go to the chef's
right.
shack.
Thank
over
you,
here, so.
Thank you, and may we pass this on to you.
My daughter has one.
Great,
there, so
great.
Thank you.
All right. I'm SB Barber, and this is GMNLive.com TV and radio, taking it to the streets. We are conducting on the spot opinions from individuals in the Twin Cities. We're right downtown, 9th and Nicollet Mall, and we want to know, what does bullying look like? What do you think about it? Can it? What's going on? We need to hear your opinion. You said something that really struck me.
Hi, my name is Doreen, and I'm from Minnesota. I'd like to tell you about bullying. Bullying is not allowed, because when I was a little girl going to school, this actually hurts me, because when I was young, bullying went on and it was around me, and I want you all to know that it only leads to drugs, it leads to nastiness, and it leads to people being behind bars, and it's just not worth it.
And you also said that if you had known what you know now, and if bullying hadn't happened to you, what did you say?
That I probably would have turned out a whole heck of a lot better. I could have stayed in school. I could have loved school. I don't have that kind of education, and God knows, you kids out there, stop bullying. Please.
And you just heard it, Stop Bullying Now movement is on the streets of the Minneapolis downtown city.
Thank you.
Well, we are witnessing and seeing by taking it to the streets that it's not about economics. It's not about race. I believe it's a lack of compassion, outright lack of compassion. All right, we're going to be talking with some other individuals to get their perspectives. And as you can see, thus far, we've talked with young people. We've talked with parents. And everyone has an opinion, and that's why we're taking it to the street. Right. Hello, sir. I'm with GMNLive.com Radio, Stop Bullying Now movement. We're bringing it to the streets to hear what you think about No Bully Zones, Stop Bullying Now. Has it happened to you in your life?
I think it happens to everyone eventually sometime in their life, either as a child or an adult. But what in particular do you mean?
As it relates to our children and as an adult, but if you have any insight on children that are being bullied, or what we can do to make them feel more comfortable about speaking out on bullying, especially with where their parents are concerned.
Well, I think especially with technology nowadays, cyberbullying has become an increasingly large issue, and it just needs something that's discussed about in the household and monitored by parents as well. That's my opinion.
That's great, because then you have a You have a platform, you have a table where you can hear your children and hear what's going on with them and make some differences there.
Yeah, instead of assuming, just take some actions and be proactive about it.
Excellent. And your name?
Nick.
Nick. Thank you, Nick.
You bet.
And we are downtown Minneapolis, GMNLive.com, TV and radio, taking it to the streets as usual. Stop bullying now. Listen, for those of you who are catching this, coming up August 27th at the Capri Theater. That's in the historic location, over 75 years old facility, right in the heart of North Minneapolis. From 4 to 6 p.m., some of the most accomplished individuals will flank the panel alongside myself as moderator and Devin Miller, who's now running for St. Paul School Board. That's how passionate he is about making a difference. And these individuals are taking the time out. Politicians, playwrights, media personalities, music industry individuals, parent advocates, and you know what? Working class. And they're going to take the time out to at least bring up their perspectives. You don't want to miss this. Right after, from 4 to 6 p.m. at the Capri, and the tickets are free. You can go online at on Facebook, GMN Live TV, or Stop Bullying Now Movement, and reserve your ticket free. Free. Come on, family. If you've got some questions, politicians, parents, if you think that you have an opinion that's not being heard and you want to make a difference, come on out to Stop Bullying Now Forum 2 at the Capri Theater, August 27th. Right after the forum, guess what? Non-stop, beginning at 7 o'clock, 50 minutes, 8 o'clock, 50 minutes, 9 o'clock, counting down 50 minutes, non-stop hip-hop music. And these are artists that have come together with the GMN Live Network to talk to you about bullying. But they're going to do it in their own way. Non-stop, non-stop music concert. And then afterwards, our artists are going to spend time with our young people in a photo session. And also, you'll hear the artists at a round table. It's called Hip Hop Fest. Stop Bullying Now, Hip Hop Fest. So if we can't get it just by sitting you down and talking to you, then we're going to let the music take you where we need you to go, to at least allow you to explore Stop Bullying Now. We're on the streets in Minneapolis.
All right.
You know, it's interesting, some of the individuals that we've talked to, one individual, wow, you can see how tall he was flanking over me. As he said, he was stuffed in a locker several times, not one time, but as he mentioned, just thought it was status quo. Well, it really isn't. And that's something we have to look at, because in many cases, there are no boundaries. And what you think is okay with an individual, when you cross that line, it does not hurt. It does hurt them. Hello? All right, we are right on the corner of Nicollet Mall. What a good spot to be in. The humidity is high. My goodness, so I really appreciate those individuals that stopped and took the time to share with us from their perspective on Stop Bullying Now Movement. We want to give a special thanks to our panelists who are going to be joining us on August 27th. And we also were at the Capri on May 22nd when the tornado that devastated North Minneapolis hit. So we had to reschedule Stop Bullying Now Forum 2. And that date is etched in stone, August 27th. And then it will be followed up by a series of concerts, non-stop hip-hop music. The artist, If You Really Knew Me, and they'll give you music non-stop. Young people, $2. $2 per concert, 3 concerts, so that's $6. You can just show up, get in the line, and get ready to allow the Capri to take the roof off of Stop Bullying Now with non-stop music. All right, let's see who else is interested and willing to share their opinion right here on Nicollet Mall. Stop Bullying Now Movement Forum. Miss, hi, I'm SB Barber, And I'm with GMNLive.com TV and radio. And Stop Bullying Now movement. We're taking it to the streets as well as in forums. And we want to hear your opinion. What does bullying look like to you? And what does it mean to you when you see the bystanders not saying anything?
I guess.
Would you like to tell us who you are?
My name's Tamara. Belfield. But bullying to me is when people are like, I guess, just constantly messing with somebody and stuff and taunting them and being mean to them and stuff. But when the bystanders don't do anything, it kind of, I don't know. I guess I could say I've been a bystander before. I haven't done anything, so I can't really judge somebody off of what they haven't done or whatever. So, but I guess it's kind of not okay for them to not do anything, because sometimes kids, like, they get really depressed and, like, kill themselves and stuff. So I guess they should start doing stuff.
Tamara, how brave of you. Do you know you're doing something right now? The mere fact that you were able to say, I know I've been a bystander. I want you to look in that camera. Give us a couple of things that young people, talk to some young people, tell them what they could do, since you just reflected that there was a time you were a bystander.
They could, I don't know, talk to like a teacher or something, and or else stand up to the bully and tell them that they should stop and it's not right or something like that. But they should stop it, though.
You know, numbers really matter. Have you noticed that bullies tend to pick on folks that are alone most of the time by themselves? And usually that bully has an entourage that bully is bullying, and that's why they're hanging together. I wonder what would happen, kind of a flash mob. The students in school, knowing that it's a no-bully zone, the moment they see it, kids come out of everywhere saying, stop bullying now. What could they do if they tried it?
What could they do to, like...
What impact would that make?
People would feel more comfortable, like they would feel safe. They'd feel like they're in a safe environment and like they had the right to be where they're at without being picked on and stuff.
How brave of you. You just made up for everything. Thank you. All right, GMNLive.com, TV and radio. We're on the mall. And Ms. Tamara, let me give you your... She's got it. All right, she's got her sticker. And, you know, that's good to know that young people have an opportunity when they hear it, when they have a platform, they want to speak out. Maybe we need to give them more platforms so that they can reflect and see how can we make a difference. Well, these are young people that are saying, wow, I can't let this opportunity go by. And she could have passed it by, but she chose not to be a bystander today. So here we are in downtown Minneapolis. Stop Bullying Now movement. And coming up, we have a concert series, three nonstop concerts, August 27th, the first set. Starts at 7 o'clock, 50 minutes nonstop. I'm telling you, there will not be a break in between passing of the baton. 8 o'clock, 50 minutes. 9 o'clock, 50 minutes. It's on. And then after that, there will be individuals selected from our audience who will have the opportunity to be invited to a private after party. And there they'll have an opportunity to hobnob and talk with artists that have committed to this movement and find out more about what they can do, as well as just be connected to individuals that are making a difference. These artists are coming from hip-hop, spoken word, rap, and you know, not too long ago in Minneapolis, Pastor Stacy Jones and his wife Trenice Jones launched Operation Hip-Hop 2011. So you want to mark your calendars. 2012 is coming up. And that's when these artists come together and they collectively look at outreach platforms and how they can make a difference through their music. These are individuals that are saying, Hollywood didn't call us, Hollywood can't make us, and we want to be exactly what God has called us to be. All so right, that's here exciting. We are, sir. Can we talk with you just for a moment? Stop Bullying Now. And you can break that seal, get it to a young person. I'm SB Barber. We're right here on the Nicollet Mall and in the humid heat, so I'm going to make this real quick for him. Sir, what's your opinion on bullying? What does it look like to you? Were you a victim? Were you a bystander? Or what can you say? Would you like to identify yourself?
Sure. My name is Bo Schaefer. My partner is actually Jamie Nabuzny, who is working on going across schools across the country to speak about bullying, how they can make a difference and making sure that they are supporting the students and making sure that they are talking to the bystanders and really making that change and standing up and speaking out to protect all the students.
You know, we just had a young lady moments before you, and she said she was a bystander. I told her that was courageous of her, because today she said, I will not be a bystander anymore.
It starts with that.
Take your spiel and go ahead and use this opportunity to push what you're doing.
What I'm doing is I am supporting my partner who is going across the country to speak to students about how they can help stand up, speak out, and protect students against bullying, because it is harassment. That's what we need to name it as, sexual harassment, verbal harassment. It is those things that we as a society need to stand up and teach our kids.
So. Where does compassion fit in that? Is there an absence of outright compassion?
I think there needs to be compassion for the victims and as well as the bullies, because the bullies, there's always that something, that underlying factor that's making them go through this process and having to make the other individuals feel, I guess, what they're feeling. So having compassion for both of them and really giving them that support and helping and not just focusing on the victim, but focusing on that bully as well.
All right. Now, through our Stop Bullying Now forums, our panelists consist of individuals like yourselves, etc., parent advocates, politicians, music industry personalities, media personalities, because we want them to take advantage of looking at what can we do to make a difference and use our platforms. Yes. So for schools, we're getting ready. August is on us. So going back to school, for those individuals that would like to get you on board or get you and your partner at the table, how do they reach you?
Reach us at jamienabuzny.com or going to Facebook and looking up Jamie Nabuzny. As well, if you're looking just for a tool, going to teachingtolerance.org and looking for Bullied. It's a video that's been produced, or documentary produced, by the Southern Poverty Law Center that's free to everybody using it for educational purposes, and it's a great tool to just open the eyes to all of the individuals. So.
You've heard it. What can I say? We accomplished it in the heat, in the humid, right in downtown Minneapolis. I'm SB Barber, and this is GMNLive.com TV and radio. Check us out on Facebook, Stop Bullying Now Movement on Facebook. Go there. Put your opinion there, your comment, and you'll be hearing from us August 27th at the Capri Theater with our panelists, our Forum 2, and then follow up with non-stop series of concerts. Hip-hop artists bringing the music hard and strong. If you really knew me, don't miss it. Stop Bullying Now Forum.
We're going to reach the streets. We're going to tell them. We're not stopping. We're going to reach the streets. We're going to tell them. We're not stopping. We're going to reach the streets, we're going to tell them. We're not stopping. We're going to reach the streets, we're going to tell them. We're not stopping.